You don't know how to add keyframes in CapCut PC. I can fix that. All right, first things first. Open up CapCut and start a new project. Then, in this timeline area, in the top left, make sure you're in the Media tab, and then click Library under that. For this example, we're going to scroll down and use the Happy New Year video, so click and drag that onto your timeline. And as you can see, it's just a Happy New Year with sparkles on the bottom of it. So now you're probably asking yourself, where are the keyframes? Well, you see these diamonds to the right side? Each of these are keyframes. You have the position and size keyframe, which is for this group of options. And you have the scale, position, and rotate keyframes, which are for these specific options. Now, keyframes are littered throughout CapCut. So once you learn how to use them, it's the same idea for all of them. So you'll have a lot of different options to play with. Now let's say you wanted to zoom out of Happy New Year. What you would want to do is grab your playhead, drag it to the point where you want to start zooming out, and then next to scale, because scale changes the size, you want to click Add Keyframe. This will change color, and a keyframe will be added on top of your content. Next, you want to grab your playhead and drag it to the point where you want to stop zooming out. Then change your scale to what you want to change it to. So I want to change mine to 50% since I'm zooming out. And as soon as I change it, this color automatically changes and a keyframe is added on top of my content. And what keyframes allow you to do is to change the value of an option over a period of time. So for this first keyframe, we are at 100%. And over this period of time, look at the scale. You see it changes and it gets closer and closer until it reaches this other keyframe, which is at 50%. So if I play this video back, it will start zooming out there and stop zooming out. And for the rest of the clip, it'll stay at 50%. So for another example, let's go to the stickers tab at the top left, and we'll add this skull onto our timeline. And of course, move the playhead to where the skull is. So let me change the size of this skull to something smaller. And let's say I wanted to move this skull from one position to another. So when the video starts, let me move the playhead to the beginning. I want this skull to be right here. So let me add the keyframe for position. And it's added on top of our content. And then at this point in time, I want the skull to be off of the screen. So I drag it all the way up there, and a keyframe is automatically added on top of my content. So when I take the playhead and go all the way back to the beginning and press play, it gradually moves off screen. It's as easy as that. Subscribe for more, and I'll catch you in the next one.